We have a couple hundred thousand fish. And each day we study about 20,000 young fish a day.
A lot of fish doing a very important job. They'll be finding out how a chemical we're exposed to every day is impacting our health.
And the genetics in zebrafish are very, very, very similar to humans.
Oregon State University toxicologist Robert Tangway is leading the study.
So we're really using the kind of the zebrafish as a sensor for whether a chemical is a problem or not.
That chemical is called polyfluoroalkyl, or PFAS for short. And why it's so important is that it's used in all sorts of consumer products.
One people recognize is Teflon. You know, you put your fry your egg on the pan and it doesn't stick. It's because of the properties of these materials are they things don't stick to them.
It's also used in fire suppressant materials, even water repellent clothing. The chemicals make their way into the soil, into our water, even into our food.
And you can detect them. In literally in all of us, and even people who, you know, don't live in industrialized areas are still contaminated because these compounds are so prevalent in the environment.
Preliminary studies have shown that chemicals can affect, even compromise, our immune systems, but not much else is known.
We know they're in our tissues, but we don't really know to what degree they're hazardous.
The nearly $2 million grant from the EPA will allow the scientists to study whether the chemicals or certain combinations of the chemicals impact our health. Do they cause autism, cancer, neurodegenerative diseases, or more? The scientists know they have a lot of work to do over the next 3 years, but they're confident with the help of these tiny fish, they'll learn a lot about a chemical that's been used for decades, but only beginning to be understood.
We're going to tackle a big problem, and I think we're going to have some pretty good answers.
Now the scientists say their ultimate goal is to find out which of the chemical combinations are the most toxic so that manufacturers can then decide to stop using them or consumers can choose to stop buying them.